Hi everyone, this is John. I'm in LA. Recently I was watching another photographer's video. I'm not ashamed to admit I watch other photographers and just take inspiration sometimes. And I saw where he photographed this laundromat. And I'll put a link to it up here just to give a reference. And I just thought it was really cool, just highlighting something that's very ordinary and making it, you know, very cool. And it inspired me to think, I like morning spots too, not just laundromats, but other places and things that are more personal to me. So I thought, you know, I'm gonna go look for a donut shop. As a truck passes by, I'm gonna go look for a donut shop. And so what better place than in LA called, than a place called Randy's Donuts? The problem is, I wanna show it during sunrise, and there's so many different angles. There's only one angle that works, and it's the one you find when you Google Randy's Donuts. And it's like, how do I make it interesting? So I tried the angle that I really wanted to see, you know, the sunrise in behind. But then take a look. The donut's not facing. There's a flat, big, giant donut, and it's facing like that. Not cool. So I thought I would try a different angle. So I just walked around the intersection for a little while, not in the intersection, but around it. I practice safety here, you know. I may be dumb, but I'm not stupid. So I'm set up on here on a street corner, just looking at Randy's Donuts. This is not a commercial for Randy's Donuts. I've actually never had Randy's Donuts. And I feel like I'm saying Randy's Donuts quite a lot. But that's what I'll call it, because that's what it's called. Pretty creative, huh? So I'm set up. I'm trying to decide on the exposure because, I mean, it's just simple. You just point at it and shoot. Sometimes it feels that way. But I like how there's people in front of it. The building's lit. It's also pretty cool. So I've got an F9, I just want a nice, simple f-stop, gets everything in focus. So the shutter speed's more what I'm concerned about. If I blow it out because of the lights in the bottom building, I could lose detail. But I also want the color of the sky. So I'm doing about half a second for the 2 second exposure. And I'm also timing it for cars that pass by. After my initial shot, you know, I'm gonna try getting closer. I just wanna see that, like, this is Randy's Donuts. And with the lighting, I think it's still pretty cool. It's sort of a slim window of time before just the sky gets too bright and maybe the lights turn off. I don't know, I like it with the lights on. That could be taken out of context, but anyway. So I moved across the street and I thought, you know, I'm gonna do a wide angle lens. And with that, I wanna do a panoramic because I just thought it's an iconic spot and with the lights on, it just looks really cool. And with the blue sky, it just, to me, it's very simple. And donuts, I think they should be simple. There's a lot of fancy donuts out there, which I think are just a little bit overkill, but who am I to complain? I don't miss many donuts. So I'm gonna do a quick panoramic where I'm just stitching together. I have my camera in a portrait angle, portrait mode. So I've just got it on a 2 second exposure. I've got it at F9 at 1/4 of a second. I'm just doing one photo. I'm gonna pan it. Well, that's it for now. I'm gonna go actually have a donut right now, and then I'm gonna go home. I'll see you all next time. Bye. It looks like what I looked like in my last video at Randy's Donuts. It's because it's the same day, about an hour later. Being near downtown LA, I thought, no, I got the day off. Let's do some street photography and just wander around. I think the technical term is wanderlust. I'm not sure. But it's just something I love to do with the camera. See what I can find or what just comes across me. People, places. Just alleyways, anything I could find. And let's get to it. I don't really have an agenda. I just spent an hour or so just walking around. I like to take the subway because it's easier than parking somewhere and paying a lot of money and parking several places. So I just take the subway. Who knew LA had a subway? It does. The service is a small area, but it works. Anyway, let's have some fun. Generally, when I'm doing street photography, I use a 50mm lens. It's lightweight. It's pretty versatile with focal lengths and doing landscapes and portraits and action. It's got a fast aperture, so it's pretty versatile with all kinds of lighting, whether it's daylight or at night. Another important factor is just to keep lightweight. I don't want to carry around a lot of stuff, especially when I'm walking. So it's a perfect lens for me. When I'm doing street photography, I feel a little awkward at times because partially just want to be incognito. I just want to do my photography and not bother anybody. I don't want to interrupt what I'm trying to photograph because oftentimes the candid view is what I'm going for. For someone to stop and smile or turn away, it breaks the photo. But at the same time, there's this delicate balance of respecting people. You know, there's a thing called privacy. People don't necessarily want to be photographed. They don't go outside to be photographed. And having somebody creep on them with a camera from far away or up close, or, you know, there's a fine line. So part of me, I have this delicate balance of trying to do candid, but also asking permission. And oftentimes it breaks the candid part, so it turns into a portrait versus just a candid look. But that's how it is. Something in LA that's been considered somewhat of a nuisance are these little personal street scooters. You rent them with your phone. I think they're pretty cool, but they also take up a lot of space on the sidewalk, which can make a lot of people mad. But in the name of convenience, they're pretty cool. So in some degree, they're ambiguous, and I want to photograph them as part of this urban, it's part of the urban culture now. They just kind of sprang up. Now they're all over the place, and it's hard to imagine them not being here. Yeah. Something I look for in street photography is light. I mean, sometimes light is what it is, but you can't really modify it, but you can work with it. I like these slivers of light, and it's sort of like a waiting game. I like this environment, but it's kind of boring because there's nobody in it or nothing interesting is going on. So it's just kind of waiting and waiting and waiting. And hopefully, you know, something comes across that's interesting. And so I'm gonna be waiting here for a moment. While I'm waiting, I'm noticing this reflective wall here, adding, you know, more scene to a limited scene. So I'm just waiting for something to photograph. I mean, I guess I can manipulate and move that scooter in there, but I think I've had enough scooters for now. Earlier I saw somebody walking with a ladder, but I didn't have my camera out, of course. So I'm just waiting. And waiting. And waiting. Well, I've been waiting about 15 minutes here and it's kind of a bust. So I'm gonna keep moving. Yeah, sometimes you wait and nothing happens. That's all right. Near Pershing Square, and behind me is this apartment building that's being built. And I was reading once upon a time the LA Philharmonic concert hall used to be here. And something to note that during the 30s, there was a Jewish community here that met at the Philharmonic concert hall to protest to the government to allow more Jews from Europe to come, because of what was going on in Germany, or around Europe, where, persecution against Jews. And here they were protesting to allow more Jews to come here as refugees. And ultimately, the government said no. They weren't listened to. And anyway, that happened here somewhere, a long time ago. And it makes me wonder, with other protests around the world, if perhaps we took more time to listen and not just, I don't know, have an answer, pre-made answer, but to actually listen and take a look at what's going on, where they're coming from, people are coming from. Maybe we can actually help end a tragedy or circumvent a tragedy. Anyway, let's keep going. Well, I think I'm going to call it for today, and I want to end on a photo of a guy I just met. He didn't want to be photographed, but he just stopped to talk to me for a little while, and I liked the look of his face, but he wouldn't let me photograph it. He had this sun gleaming from this reflection off a window, but he wouldn't let me do it. But he would let me photograph his hands the way they looked, so I'll end on that. Until next time, bye for now. Bye.